It was sort of like the mummy, you know, when all the bugs like crawl.
Not the bees.
Yeah. It's lovely to talk to you both about Behind Her Eyes. I felt so tense whilst watching this. Did you do anything offset to kind of relieve tensions?
Yeah, I hung out with Eve. That'll relieve anyone. She's there. It is a very tense piece. But we had, it was one of the most enjoyable experiences, actually, filming that. It was so, so fun. And not least of all, because Evie's fucking awesome. Look at her go. But it was a really nice, because I found often when you work with people, you go, oh, I work this way, you work this way. And you're respectfully like, I'll do my thing, you'll do your thing. We'll come together, we'll do our thing. But, you know, you work differently. What I loved about Eve is I was like, this person works just like me. So I felt, we could just sort of play around and have fun. And we did.
Yeah, I had a riot of a time. I was so happy to be on this job because usually when I'm on movies or anything, it's usually just one girl and a bunch of older men. Wow. And this is the first time I'd actually worked with people my own age. So I felt like I was back at school or something. I was like, this is so cool. Yeah. We're all the same age and you're not like going home to your three children and your wife. So I just had fun. Me and Tom, like, we really did get on very well. Yeah.
The first night I got to this part, to Scotland, I just texted Eve and Rob and met them in a pub and we sort of just sat there and got drunk on gin. It was great.
Yeah, it was so good. And it was the summertime, you know, summertime in Scotland, summertime in London.
Remember those midges, by the way? It's Scotland in that summer because we were right by this lake and it was literally like all of the crew had these like basically like full bodysuit net things on. Yeah. And then me and Evie were just sort of chilling in shorts and t-shirts, being like, this is just munched.
It was horrible.
Like he had been, do you remember when he had to run through that field?
Yeah.
Bless him, he looked like he'd got, it was awful. His whole leg was just covered in them.
It was sort of like the mummy, you know, when all the bugs like crawl.
Not the bees! The man.
That sounds like my worst nightmare.
Yeah. I just moved to the area.
David's kind and generous.
I work for your husband.
You work with David. Small world.
Adele seems perfect. They're both happier with me than they are with each other.
You shine.
What about your wife?
Is it happening again, David?
What are you talking about?
You know what I mean.
When I was watching this, it made me think about how appearances can be so deceptive. So I was wondering, what's the weirdest thing you learnt about each other that you otherwise wouldn't have known?
Come on. There's loads. Evie, a surprising thing about Evie is you wouldn't think it's like she sleeps. Like she is like a hibernating bear and she'd sleep. And also she managed to do it so quick. So like quite often you've only got like 40 minutes for lunch. You're like, guys, quick, get down, get your food in you. If you're lucky, look over the scene you're about to do or whatever. And I used to like finish lunch and be having a cigarette on my, and I'm like, Evie, and I knock on her door and she would just be like blackout, like completely asleep. It's quite impressive, that speed.
I actually, during that whole, the first month of the shoot, I was sleeping so much and I thought, oh God, I must be really tired. Like anytime we had about even 10 minutes during a setup, I would be asleep. And then I realized that I had been drugging myself with herbal sleeping pills or whatever. And I looked at the thing and it was like, oh, you should only take, you know, one. And I was taking three when I got home from work, you know, like 3 a.m. And I had to get up at 10 a.m. to go to work, but it doesn't kick in until like 6 a.m. So by the time I got to work, I was supposed to be asleep. And so, yeah, the first few weeks of getting to know Tom, I was asleep in my trailer the entire time. Yeah.
But I remember as well, like we got back into the hotel. I remember like, it wasn't even late. I think it was like 6 or something. And I went, oh, I'm going to have a drink in the bar. And Rob was like, yeah, I'll come and have a drink with you. And Eve just with like no shame was like, I'm going to bed.
Yeah. They were like, if you go to sleep now, that's like 16 hours of sleep. I was like,
outside.
Yeah.
How about you, Eve? Did you learn anything about Tom that took you by surprise?
I learned a lot. You know, Tom is entirely punctual. He's very, very punctual and gets a little bit hot-headed if people aren't on time. He's like obsessed with like being there. And you know, if he says, what is it you say if you're not early, you're late?
Early is on time is late, late is fired.
Exactly. That's what he's into.
Yeah. I just hate, do you know what it is? It's not necessary. I don't ever actually really resent people if they're late.
True.
I know that if I have kept someone waiting, I just sweat and it really freaks me. I hate it so much. So I tend to arrive most places about an hour early.
But you wouldn't think it when you see Tom, because he's like this cool guy. He's like wearing cool clothes, because... cool beard. You know, you think he'd rock up when he wants to rock up. But I do
rock up when I, because I said this to someone once, right? They were like, you know, why are you sort of like, I'm chill because I'm always early. So I'm never rushing. I'm like, do you know what? I'm where I need to be. I got half an hour, I'll chill. So when everyone else turns up sweating and late, I'm like, what's up?
So much of our lives are shaped by other people.
You need to learn to control your dreams, Louise. You and me. We're special.
The series is so binge-worthy. I couldn't wait to watch the next episodes. Are there any shows that you're watching at the moment on Netflix that you're completely obsessed with?
Below Deck.
It's great.
It's so good.
Do you know what that is, Olivia?
I've heard great things, and I've heard loads about the captain on it, but I've not actually seen it. But I know that people have this strong love for the captain.
He has
great taglines like, oh, you really screw the pooch on that one.
It's a great show, but I do think it's sort of like, after a while it's kind of overloaded. I was like two series, I think, and then they were like, oh, now you can watch the Mediterranean version. I was like, wow, that's a lot of
people
cleaning a boat. I was obsessed, because we got asked this recently, and I was utterly obsessed with last time we spoke, Lupin on Netflix is just one of the best things. I loved every second and just mortified. But another thing, during lockdown, have you guys watched Succession?
I've not seen Succession.
I'm late to that party. Oh my God, it's so good.
Incredible.
Literally, you know, when the lockdown eased, I went for brunch with two of my friends, and they were talking about it, and I went, I've never seen that. And both of them like dropped their knives and forks and were like, you have to go home now. Yeah.
It's seriously on another level.
Good. It's so, all of them are, the writing is just stunning, and then all of them are incredible. And you know that something's really good when you're grieving the fact that they haven't made, and we have to wait for season three to be made. Equally with Lupin, I'm like, come on, make it.
I drive around New York thinking about the characters in Succession as if they're real people. Like, I wonder what they're doing right now.
I could honestly talk to you both about series all day, but they're giving me the wrap. So thank you so much for talking to me. Huge congrats on the series. I can't wait for everyone to watch it.
Thank you so much.
This is Hits Radio.